everyone. I'm here to give you another at-home workout, body rock style. We have just minimal equipment required. Just make sure you've got a yoga mat, washcloths if you're on a hard surface floor. If you only have rug or carpet, no problem. Using either sliding discs or like the lid to Tupperware or a salad bowl, something like that will help you slide. And a set of weights. I've got 5 pounds. Feel free to go down or up with whatever you're comfortable with. If you don't have weights at home, you can use anything. Canned food, bottles of booze, bubbly water, whatever floats your boat. So we're gonna get started. I got my ghetto speakers kind of bumping here. So we're gonna begin with a warm up, some deep inhales and squats. So let's get started here. Got my timer, and we're set. So feet are hip distance apart. You're gonna squat down, inhale those arms up, and exhale down. Coming into that little bit of a squat here, take that deep inhale. Now on this next one, we'll take that big inhale, and we're gonna squat down. Find that low squat here, keeping the navel to the spine, shoulders out of the ears, arms long. We'll begin to pulse up an inch and down, up an inch and down. We'll go back into those big inhales, creating some heat in the body. In 4, 3, 2, and 1. On that third one, we hold our arms up, sink back nice and low again. Same thing, you're nice and low, you're pulsing up an inch and down. Up an inch and down, checking in on those shoulders. I know I just had to pull mine out of my ears. Let those quads get a little fired up, squeezing your glutes. We're up one more time for those inhales in 3, 2, and 1. Third one now, we're all keeping the arms up, sinking back low, but we're gonna go for a full range squat here. So you're coming up, and at the tip top, I want you to come to your tiptoes, then take it back down. 2, 3, and 4. Squeeze up. Finding those tiptoes. Staying in both heels equally. We're gonna be transitioning to a plank to peg in 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. So go ahead, find your hand on your mat here, and you wanna put your toes on your washcloth here, because we're gonna be simulating that plank to peg position here. So option to put these, come to your knees here, just put the washcloths there so you can slide. From here, we're gonna meet in that tall plank, fire everything up, that belly button's to your spine, shoulders are over the wrists, fire up your quads. We're gonna really pull from that low belly as we come up, 2, 3, and 4. Inhale, out, 2, 3, and 4. So taking that slow body rock 4 count here, scooping with the low belly to bring those hips up. Press into the palms to try to keep the shoulders out of the ears. Exhale up. 2, 3, and 4. Inhale out. 2, 3, and 4. We're going to be transitioning this to a cannonball on this next one. So let's meet in that tall plank. 3, 2, and 1. This time we drop that pike. We exhale, bend those knees. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Inhale out. Same rules apply. You want to try to stop those knees just underneath the hips here, bending to that 90 degrees. We're gonna meet and hold in the tall plank in 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now we've got a set of push-ups here. You're lowering down, 2, 3, and 4. Press up. Now option to take these on your knees. Option for a little challenge, raising one of your legs. Press up. Just 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. We're holding it up here. Now we're gonna get into a quick set of mountain climbers. Opposite knee, opposite elbow. Just give it 10 more seconds here. We're gonna come on to our forearms to finish up this warm up. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Take it to your forearms here. Square off those hips. Again, that belly glued to the spine. Keep in those quads fired up. Push that breath through the heels. We're gonna tap out. Left foot out and center. Right foot out and center. We've got just 15 seconds here. Then we're gonna be getting into our legs. Pressing into those forearms, keep those shoulders out of the ears. Just 3, 2, and 1. Come onto your knees, open up into a child's pose. We've got a heavy glute and hamstring focused leg day. So for this, we're gonna start with our speed skater. I'm gonna get my mat out of my way so I've got more room on my hard floor. So from here, we're gonna go in to left leg speed skater. So you're gonna want your washcloth under the right foot. Coming in to that low lunge. So from here, sink back, bottom down and back. Find that low lunge. Your abdominals are lifted, that chest is open. You're rooted in that left heel and your bottom's down and back to keep the knee behind the toes. You're out in your lowest lunge and you're gonna hold it there. So we're in that isometric hold. I like to keep my arms out in front. Arms can go to the small of your back if you'd like. We're gonna bend that knee in to meet us in that low squat. And extend it out. Slow and controlled. Immediately firing up that glute and quad in the left side. Staying nice and low here. Sinking down a little lower if you've got it in you. Finding that comfort in the discomfort. We're gonna let that washcloth leg just come in a couple of inches and out. Washcloth leg, right leg, what have you. Let it just come in a few inches, shortening that range. Firing up those quads in the left. Almost there. We're gonna hold it out in 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hold that leg out, sink down a little bit lower. You got this. We'll finish up with half range. We're gonna rise, slight reprieve for that left leg, then take it right back down to your lowest lunge. Coming up about halfway, squeeze that glute, pressing into that left heel the whole time. You're just 10 more seconds here. You got this. Just 4, 3, 2, and 1. Ouch. All right, we are gonna get into a set of deadlifts here. So we're gonna need your weight, just because you're gonna need a little bit of something for an opposing force. Lots of balancing here. So I'll show you from the side what that looks like. I'm gonna use my mat so there's a little bit of cushion here. I did this yesterday and found the hardwood hurt. So press into your left heel. And this, I know we're more in our heel when we're on the machine. You can be slightly more evening out that weight distribution in the foot for this while we're on the floor. So weights are in front of you. You're balancing on that left leg. Keep a slight micro bend. We're about 98% straight in that left leg. Abdominals lifted. You're gonna begin to bend down. Keeping that belly lifted. That right leg comes out behind you. Squeeze through that left glute to rise. Right leg comes down. So igniting that left glute the whole time. Working on those stabilizing muscles, all those tiny muscles that support the larger here. The abdominals stay engaged the whole time to support the spine. Squeeze through that glute. You should feel that nice stretch in the back of your left leg and the hamstring. A lot of lengthening there. And then as you're coming up, immediately engage that left glute. This next one, you're gonna bring right knee in and then right knee out. Coming back down. Right knee comes in, right knee comes out. I'll show you what that looks like. Whoa. There you go. Now we're gonna hold that knee in. Okay, see? Real time, right? It's hard. Going up and out with that right leg. You're gonna bring it back center. Now keep that right leg bent and you're gonna lower down. 2, 3, 4. Then just come up about 2 counts. Just a single leg squat here, squeezing through that left glute. Weights can come down, belly lifted. Just 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Check it out. From here, we're gonna get into an oblique sweep. No equipment, but you're gonna wanna be on your mat here. So, from here, we're gonna come down into that all fours position. You're gonna take the left leg out. Now, just as we are when we're on the carriage, you wanna lean slightly into that left side. So you're pressing a little bit more into that palm, trying to keep the hips parallel with the floor. And now you're gonna lift left leg up and sweep it straight behind the body. Coming out. Lift up and sweep right behind the body. Again, I feel my hips wanting to lean into that right side. So lean, press a little bit more into that left side, left palm. Keeping your belly lifted. On this next one, we're gonna bring it out, lift it back, bend in for hamstring curl, extend it out. We're gonna continue to hold that hamstring curl, send it out. Bending in 90 degrees, flexing that foot, lengthening out. We'll begin to let that knee come down into the chest a bit, keeping that foot flexed. We come all the way up, stamp as high as you can take it, lower down. Good. We'll hold it up in 4, 3, 2, and 1. Holding it up to your highest point. We're gonna hit those little pulses with no momentum. It's up and down, up and down. Give me 10 more seconds, just like this. Four, three, two, and one. Okay, a little shake here. Our next one, we're gonna get into a little bit of a side plank here. Coming up with your right arm being the kickstand, your right knee down. You're gonna be squeezing through your right glute too for to aid in that stabilization. We're gonna come up with that top left leg and lower down. So think of it as kind of like legless, we're in leg sweeper, just less weight, and we're not fully reclined. But still engaging that right oblique. Keeping your abdominals lifted here, finding your range of motion and height, isolating outer glute, outer thigh here. We hold that leg up in 3, 2, and 1. Flex the foot, bend, bringing that heel to the glute. Stay with me here. We'll hold that leg out. Finish with a quick set of rainbows in 4, 3, 2, and 1. So that leg's gonna lengthen out. Doesn't matter which direction you start. You're tracing that semicircle. These are really tough. Final 15 here. Just 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, we're gonna finish this part of our leg series with bridge curls. I'm just shifting my mat here, coming down to your back. Let that spine press into the mat, lift your abdominals, press into the heels. You're gonna lift your hips up, squeezing as tight as you can with those glutes, high as you can, and then lower down, articulating through the spine, putting on the brakes each time you lower, squeezing. Up, 2, 3, and 4. You're down, 2, 3, and 4. Knees up, 2, 3, and 4. This next one, as we come up, we're gonna hold. Meet me there. Hold it high, abdominals are lifted, glutes are nice and tight, shoulders out of the ears. Hold it high, see if you gain another inch here. We'll let those knees come in, open up. Knees are coming in, squeeze, slowly release out, trying to keep that height. And nice tuck in your glutes. We'll finish with pulses. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Still keeping that height. Pulse up and down, up and down. You can increase that pace if you want. Just get that extra booty burn. Almost there. Just 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Whew. Go ahead and give your knees a hug. Little release for the small of your back. We got a quick set of obliques here. I'm switching my mat. We're gonna do a set of dancing cannonballs. So we'll hit both sides first. So you wanna grab both of your washcloths. And for this one, you're gonna wanna keep your feet pretty close together. So my hands were meeting in that tall plank. My feet are pretty close together. And before you turn, you wanna keep them close together. Keep your abdominals lifted. shift, open the hips to the left elbow. Exhale, bend those knees to the left elbow. Inhale, lengthen out. We're gonna square it off, rotate towards right side. Exhale, bend those knees to the right elbow. Hands, shoulders stay square with the wall in front of you, or whatever's in front of you. Exhaling as you're bending those knees in. Inhale as you reset and lengthen. We're just 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. You're gonna come down to your forearms. You move your left cuff here. We're going to cross left foot over right. So from here, my hips are opened up to the right, my right side. My shoulders are staying squared in front of me. I'm pressing through my forearms, trying to create distance from my shoulders and my ears, lifting my left hip up a bit, engaging that oblique. I'm gonna press up an inch and hold. We're up one more inch and hold. Pressing through those forearms, keeping that twist, bringing sensation in the left side body. We're lifting up one more inch and hold. Stay with me here, 10 seconds. We'll square off our plank. Just 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. We're squaring off our plank. We'll finish with left side hip dip. We dip to the left, center. To the left, back center. Almost there. 10 more seconds. Leading with that oblique. Give it 4, 3, 2, and 1. Take it to your knees. Twig child's pose. We're getting back into those legs. So, grab that washcloth. We're gonna begin with that speed skater leg. So, from here, now I'm in that right foot, grounded in that right heel. All my body weight's over that right foot. Right heel. Sinking back, bottom down and back, your abdominals lifted, that chest stays open. Again, arms out in front or behind you, whichever you prefer. We're in that nice low lunge. Lock it in there. We exhale, bend that knee in to meet us in our low lunge. Let it just glide on that floor and stay rooted in that right heel. Checking in. You know, we're always so fortunate with those mirrors to check our form here. So check in, make sure that knee is not creeping over that toe, those toes, in this low position. Think sinking down and back. Let the strength of that fresh right quad take over, and that right glute. We're beginning with that shortening range with the left leg. Just bring it in a few inches and out. Staying super low in that right. Maybe you can sink a little lower as you guide that leg in a few inches. Breathe with it. A reminder to myself. So much harder doing it with you guys. Stay with it. We're almost there. We'll sink down low and hold in 4, 3, 2, and 1. Sink down low. We're still holding steady. Arms can come out. Stay with me. We'll finish at halfway, rising through that right leg. You're up. 2, 3, 4. Take it down. That lowest spot where you started. You're halfway up. I'm just gonna breathe. I hope you are too. We're almost there. We take it up in 3, 2, and 1. Right side is always harder for me. All right. Grabbing your weights for that deadlift. I'm going to bring this out this way a little bit so you can see that I don't kick my media cabinet. So those weights are in front of us. Again, your abdominals are lifted. Steady on that right foot. You're in that heel so you can really access those hamstrings and glutes, but your weight distribution can go a little bit more towards the ball of your foot as well. You don't want to get too much strain in your ankle. So weights in front of you, abdominals lifted. Right leg is about 98% straight here, not a full lockout. And you're up, squeezing through that right glute. Squeeze through that right glute. Lots of concentration here. It's a balancing act. Just let that right glute take over. Feel that nice stretch in the hamstring as you bend pull forward. Now, on this next one, you'll let that leg come in. I'm just turning underhand grip with my weights so they're out of the way. Take it back down. And this is where it gets tricky. If you're feeling any strain, adding back in that full range motion, go ahead and just hold it here with the knee in and then out. Reminding you what that looks like. It's in, then out. Or you can drop that all together and just continue that deadlift. That final piece, we're gonna hold it here. Just letting that leg, little hip flexor work. Whew. Now, we're gonna meet back down. It's even hard for me. Yeah, shake out that right foot. We'll meet down. Let's finish strong for those single leg squats. You'll bend that left knee. Come down nice and low. Your lowest part here. Then you're just up, two, down, two. That final burn, hitting the quad and that right glute. Lots of balance. You got this. 10 more seconds. Just 4, 3, 2, and 1. Those are hard. Get your weights out of the way. We're gonna get into that oblique sweep. So coming into that tabletop position, my palms are on my mat for that little bit of push for my wrists. Let your right leg come out, abdominals lifted, trying to keep those hips squared with the mat. You're lifting up. And swooping that leg back. Come back up. Lift up, engaging from the right oblique, then bring that leg behind you. Again, that little balancing act, we're off center here in this tripod. So you're gonna press a little bit more into that right palm. Lift up, sweep back. Full range, just a little longer than we add. Those hamstring curls. Now on this next one, leg comes up, sweep back, extend out, flex the foot, curl in, and we're holding it up there. So lengthen out, flex the foot, bend it in, keeping that belly button lifted, pressing, toe through the palms, no tension in that neck. Flexing that foot to access those hamstrings. No weight, and you can still feel it. We're gonna let that knee come in 4, 3, 2, and 1. You'll let it come in, keep that foot flexed. then press it up to the sky, squeezing through, lower down. Check in, don't let that belly drop. We'll hold it up, four, three, two, and one. You're pulsing up and down, up and down. Shorten range of motion, maximum height you can muster. No momentum, just pulsing up. 8 more seconds. Raises here. So I'm going to have my left knee, left hand on my mat here. Lengthen out my right leg. Right left hip length engaged. Abdominals lifted. Here we go. That right leg lifts up. Now already I feel the difference in my body. That left leg has such a greater range of motion. So if you feel those imbalances, that's okay, it's good to just notice them. And you give them an extra love in your cool down and stretching. The words of this song are rock your body, take it slow. So fitting for Body Rock, yeah? Lift your leg up, hold it there, flex that foot, bend it in, that heel to your booty, lengthen out. Almost there, we finished with those rainbows. Four, three, two, and one, keeping that leg up. You'll go to the front and to the back. It's 15 seconds. Literally have no range on this right side. What's going on with this right hip? We'll find out. Ooh, still feel it though. Give it just 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Holy moly. All right. Let's do, I've got a reclined inner thigh movement for you as we get into center core and finish with upper body. So one last little leg move. Come down onto your back. Again, release the small of your back. A little shake, a little shimmy. Feel your spine connect with your mat. Lift your abdominals and press that low back. So that means a little bit of a pelvis tilt here. You're gonna bring knees to tabletop position. Keep your abdominals lifted, pressing that low back into the mat. Keep your heels together. You're gonna extend those legs out in those frog legs. Bring it in. Squeeze the legs together, holding tension and pushing in the heels so you squeeze and access those inner thighs. Then lengthen the legs straight to the ceiling. Come out wide in a reclined split. Squeeze in, tabletop, heels together, press out, squeezing in, squeeze with those knees and inner thighs, come up straight, come out wide. Heels together, press out for those frog legs, bring them in, squeeze like you've got a thigh master there, holding tension, straight legs, point the toes, bend them down, we're almost there. We're gonna hold just those splits. Keep that low belly glued in, small of your back glued into your mat as well. Let's find that halfway zone in 3, 2, 1. You're halfway there, pulse in.
squeeze those inner thighs. Keep your abdominals lifted. We're gonna get into a quick core flow. 4, 3, 2, 1. Whew. Bring those knees in. In true Kellie fashion, we're gonna go over probably a minute or so. But we want it all in, yeah? Okay. So knees in tabletop, hands behind your head. We're gonna just start with some center crunches. Now as you're coming up, you wanna keep your elbows open, your chin tucks a bit, and you're squeezing from your abdominals, but you wanna feel a curl begin to, as you come up from just below that breast line. We're not pulling, no tension from that neck. We're gonna hold it up in 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hold it here. We lengthen that right leg. You're gonna lower it down and up. Holding that crunch. We're gonna begin to add a slight rotation here. Or full rotation. In 4, 3, 2, 1. Left arm comes up, raises by that right knee, and now you get a slight reprieve. As the right leg comes out, you lower your head down. You're up, straight leg, add a rotation. We're gonna do this for the other side in 4, 3, 2, and 1. So reset, you're in that tabletop position. You're gonna take that exhale, crunch up, let the left leg come out. You're holding center as you lower down with the left. Exhale as the leg comes up. We begin those rotations. That right arm releases from behind the head. Add that rotation, lower the head down. As the left leg comes down, we're almost there. Finish with upper body. 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right. Now you're gonna grab your weights for this. I'm gonna come up to standing. You choose what feels best for you. We are gonna begin with front raises. So I'm gonna be feet about hip distance apart, roll my shoulders down my back, open up my chest. Get soft in your knees, so your abdominals are lifted, your glutes are engaged too, so you've got that stable base. Drop the shoulders as you bring the weights out in front, wrists in line with the shoulders, lower down. Nice and slow here. We're gonna begin alternating lateral raises. So this next one, same stance in those legs. We're coming down, go back out front. Coming out wide. We're almost there. We're gonna hold it up laterally. 4, 3, 2, and 1. You're lowering down an inch and up, squeezing into the tip tops of your shoulders, kind of leading with those elbows a bit. Just 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. We're gonna get into leaning tricep kickbacks here. So you can be standing, you can be on your knees. I'm gonna roll my shoulders down my back, fold my upper body over, still lifting the abdominals. Our elbows are glued to the sides of our body. Weights facing in. We're just gonna extend from those elbows, hinging, curling in, keeping the arms steady. So always important, scan the body here. Just check in. We And with that tension, those shoulders creep up to our ears. So make sure you're pulling them down, squeezing the shoulder blades. Just letting those arms raise the sides of the body. We're gonna begin a triple pulse. You're up, two, three, curl in. You're up, two, three, curl in. Up, two, three, curl in. This next one, we'll pulse three times and hold. Hold it there. See if you gain any extra height. Squeeze through those triceps. Let it burn. Trust your strength. You're just 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, we're gonna take this down. Very quick set of chest press and end in a row with boat pose. We're off 40 minutes here. We're gonna be at like 43. It'll be fun. Good, yeah? Okay, so arms up, bringing them in, wrists in line with shoulders, pressing out, squeezing with those chest muscles. Press it up, not here long. We gotta fit it all in, yeah? We're gonna find that halfway zone. Hold it there and let it come in an inch, out, in an inch, out. So you're kind of keeping those shoulders down. You'll feel a squeeze and a burn at the tip top, but just this shortened range of motion. Find a lot of burn, a lot of control in the strength of those pecs right now. Just 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, take it to your bottom. Hang on to those weights. So get your sit bones on there. Get a little bit of a tuck. So you've got a C curve in your spine. So we're losing the core to stay stable in this position. Heels can be on the mat here. Rolling my shoulders down the back. My weights are coming out in front of me. And I'm just raising the side of my body. Scooping, squeezing into those shoulder blades. Scooping my low belly. Making any adjustments as needed. If you feel body fatigue and your muscles are getting tired, just try to think of those little deepening cues. Always correcting our form. We're almost there. We're gonna see if we can finish in a boat pose, continuing this row. So I'm doing a low row since my weights feel a little bit heavy. Coming up. Feel that scoop in the belly, so you're stable here. Arms out. Squeeze back. Squeeze into those shoulder blades. Control those arms out. We've got 20 more seconds here. No variations. Just 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now final squeeze. Arms are gonna come up. Scoop that belly, protect your spine. Just hold it with me. 20 seconds here. We're almost there. You may feel a little bit shaky. I'm right there with you. Give me just 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Whew. Thank you so much for joining me. Do not forget to stretch. So, so important. Get in that child's pose. Open up the knees. Let the toes point together. Sink your bottom. Hips back. Lengthen out the arms. Just let that breath come back to normal. Don't forget to stretch and hydrate. Thanks so much for joining me. Hope you're all doing well. Bye.